റെഡി? ബിസിനസ് കുഴപ്പമില്ലല്ലോ, ഒന്നും ചിന്തിക്കണ്ട, ഒരു കുഴപ്പമില്ല. പിന്നെ ഓടിക്കുന്ന ഫോമിലാക്കുന്ന കാര്യം ഞാൻ ഏറ്റു, അതിനെ പറ്റി ഈ അറിയണ്ട. When I was studying in 7th standard, no, one chapter were there studying Olympics. I was never thought that I can participate in the Olympics. I used to think, oh, this much and all, what of the Olympics bulk in one chapter was. I was reading. I've not thought that even in future I can participate. And all so muscular, and they do so very active, and I'm so scared to run with them. Like my whole body is their one leg that time. But for me, I don't want to run in like, though I'm running heats, I don't want to be in the last. I wanted like, even if I can't come in the first also, but I should be in the middle. But still I finished 6th in the heats.
Surya first.
Before Moscow Olympics, I participated in the Pakistan invitation meet in Karachi and won 4 gold medal. But my first flight trip is Moscow. First Pakistan I went without reservation, and from there in reservation, 2 trains. If young mind nowadays, the new generation, if they goes like that, they will not come again for the sports field. And that type of experience for me. Lot of trouble for me because I'm a 16-year-old girl. And without a reservation while going, I think, I don't know, some people from outside, they have done, I don't know what to say. They do take some, I mean, kalladathin chaana kedutha kari avaru. Aa ingane kalik pillar aayirikkum povuna valiki porathunu. Aa edutha erinja chaana ende mothekka vannu veene. Annu povumbo, aa odikondirikkum train. So, നമുക്കെന്തോ മാതിരി ആവില്ലേ, റിസർവേഷനും ഇല്ല, ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടി പോവുകയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ പുറത്തുനിന്ന് വന്ന ചാണകം ഫേസിലേക്ക് വന്ന് വീഴുക. ഫസ്റ്റ് ടൈം ഗോയിങ് ഫോർ ദ മോസ്കോ ഒളിമ്പിക്സ്, ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വെരി, ഫോർ മീ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ത്രിൽ ടു സീ ദ ഒളിമ്പിക് സ്റ്റേഡിയം. ആൻഡ് ഐ എം വെരി ത്രിൽഡ്. ആൻഡ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ടൈം ഐ എം ജസ്റ്റ് ഗോയിങ് ഇവൻ ഇൻ ദ ഫ്ലൈറ്റ്. ആൻഡ് ബട്ട് ഫോർ മീ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് സിക്നസ് ഇൻ ദ ഫ്ലൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് സെൽഫ്. ആൻഡ് നോട്ട് അറ്റ് ഓൾ ഇൻ എ ഗുഡ് മൂഡ് ആഫ്റ്റർ റീച്ചിങ് ദിയർ, ഫുൾ വൊമിറ്റിംഗ്. Because it's a first time now, like flying, it is not easy, maybe first time. So long time flying in the air, it is made me little, my head got heaviness and started vomiting. When we went to the Moscow Olympics welcome center, they will give you the drinks, no, like welcome drink they give. I don't know what thing I have taken from the, because I am so thirsty and so tired. I took some drink from there, and after that I feel again some problem. I don't know what I took, maybe a wine, I don't know, something. And I had some lot of problem in this and started vomiting, and that day was very difficult for me. But 16-year-old girl going outside the country, and the big, it was a very big stadium, and it was the same type building, Olympics villages. And when you go to the room, from the room to mess and room to the other places and all, it looks almost same building. But it one small vehicle also will be there to surround, no, like to go to the mess and all the places, warm up area and all those things. One small vehicle also will go from my hostel to my flat to that building, maybe 3 times I gone, and then I will keep on mark, then I started going to the mess, because others are all seniors. No company for me. One lady was there, Gita Sushi, 800 meters runner. She's very senior to me. Nobody is there. I go almost alone there. And when I go to the ground, the chief coach was there, Saini sir and all, he helps. Because my coach didn't come in 1980 Moscow Olympics, he didn't come. But with the Saini sir, chief coach, I went with him. He helped me. And one basketball coach was there, Malayali, he was also in the team. And sometimes he helps me. And or counting in the one mark, and after reaching the mess itself, that time Indian team used to bring take the cooks also there for food. They make good puris and chapatis and all those they'll make. For me, I'll take lot of time to reach there. Now by that time, that all Indian food will finish. I will try the continental again, other mess. It was like, it's very funny.
So, what was the feeling when you stood on the track at the Olympics? Were you over?
Olympics, na 1980. I don't want to come in last. That is, I don't like running in last. I know that I'm not going to win because they are so, I told you, they are so explosive and they are so strong. But still 15-20 meters, I ran with them because it's a very good start. After that, they were accelerating so fast and they were accelerating, but I finished sixth. So I am happy. Running last, I can't imagine. That time response, because you will remember all those things. Why? Because something will hit in your heart, no? When we were going, after reaching Delhi, we could get give the accommodation in some hotel. Hotel name and all, I'm not remembering. That time, 1980 Moscow, the hockey won the gold. So I saw that hockey match. I was enjoyed winning the gold medal Indian team. The Bhaskaran was the captain of that, this, no? Then they were there and we were there and we all going for in the lift to the room or maybe mess or somewhere. But everybody will be there with Bhaskaran and people. Everybody will neglect others, no? When you win, people will be there for you, people only. Those who won, you will be with them, you will motivate them, you will encourage them, you will interview them. But others you will neglect. So that the age, that my age is 16 only. Lot of feelings for us, na? Like especially for me. Nobody is taking care, and taking care only for that is there. That then within this 4 years, lot of change. It will come. It will change the side and the side. It is like that. I started winning the meet internationally. Then slowly thinking in the mind 400 meter hurdles in 1984 Olympics, my coach Nambiar sir has changed my event to 100, 200 to 400. Because first I should run 400, then only I can run 400 hurdles. Why? Because I learned hurdles when I was small, 60 meter hurdle, 80 meter hurdles and all. And I have a good stride pattern and I have a good frequency and smooth running. I missed the bronze by 1/100th of a second only because of lack of exposure. First itself, I qualified for the Olympics with B standard. But though I came first and qualified, I am not satisfied. I wanted to go to the Olympics with the qualifying A qualification mark. So after 15 days, actual selection had come, final selection in Delhi, that is synthetic track. And me and Valsama both ran. The second race in my life, 400 hurdles, I ran 55.7 seconds and qualified for the Olympics, and it was one of the best performance in the world at that time. Somebody had come from Los Angeles also to interview me at that time. So with this I went to Los Angeles, only two races. But see, thinking that running two and participate in the Olympics, it's a very excellent performance of mine.
And no international exposure?
No exposure. Only this two competition also with 30-40 meters lead. What competition is this? With that only I ran. Then 20 days before I went to Los Angeles, Nambiar sir, no, my coach, he entered my name in pre-Olympics. He came to know that there is a pre-Olympics in Inglewood. So I will get one exposure thinking that, and he entered my name there, and I participated with Judy Brown King, American, that silver medalist, no? And I beaten her and came first. I ran with her and came first. That is only with that confident I participated in the Los Angeles Olympics.
P.T. Usha is a lady that some people think could win this race from India in lane 5. Really unheard of when she showed up in Los Angeles, 20 years old. The Asian continental record holder, but got no pre-Olympic publicity, really, and here she is with a chance.
There, actually, Judy Brown came first in the heats. The semi-finals, I overtook her and I came the first in the semi-final. Normally, I go for 6-2, 6-3 seconds first hurdle. That is my end, this 6-2, 6-3. Then I'll manage up to 5. And from there, if I do all-out race, my full 17 stride it will be. I am confident. After 5 hurdle, I am so confident to run. I like to run. So, that day, actually, I ran semi-final 6.8 only. So my coach told me that you ran only first hurdle 6.8. Normally your performance is 6.2. If you go for 6.2, you will be the winner. He told me. Then my concentration is full on 6.2, running 6.2, and correctly I took the start. There is no problem at all, no nervousness, nothing. It's a perfect start. But it is my unluck, no, that the girl won Debbie Flinto from Australia. I think she was in the sixth track. After one step, after start, one step, she has get falling down, no? Like, the starter recalled the race.
Women's 400 meter hurdles. It's a fair start with Brown in lane 8, and Flintoff has pulled up in lane 6, and it's also a false start, a false start.
After one step only it happened. I don't know why he called. When it comes to start, he can. But he did that. But then for me, I got lot of tension, like lot of concentration. I did that and so suddenly got nervousness and full tensed, and my hand was shivering and didn't get any concentration. Again, I went for the start and It's a very slow start. I took 6.9 seconds. See, 6.2 and 6.9 where it stands. It means always I'm very slow. I know that after crossing first hurdles, I'm closing last. But still I could not accelerate because first itself I went slow. No, my race actually, I go first 3 hurdles good. Then I relax little bit. Then again I start after 5 hurdles. That is my race, so that you can pull here. There it changed. First hurdle slow. I know that I went slow. So first 3 hurdle was slow. I was crossing last. And it's the wrong area. That area was wrong, no? That side, that area, that opposite side. There I started accelerating because I am last crossing. I started accelerating. When it came to 5th, I had come to 6th position. When it came to 6th position, 7th hurdle, I had come to 4th. When it came to 8th hurdle, I had come to 2nd. Because wrong side I could accelerated, no? So, when it was in the 10th hurdle, I was in the own hurdle, over the hurdle, and she was landing, Judy Brown King. So, from there, we were like sprinting, because I started accelerating the wrong area. That is why my pulling was not there. But still, my body is in ahead. I could have dipped my chest and could have won the medal.
And the race is never over until you cross the finish line. Not looking at anyone, just giving it all she has. And this is what it takes to win a medal at the Olympic Games.
It's clear that Brown wins the silver, and then we suspected that the Romanian, and when we look at the replay, I'll stick by that in lane 3, at least for the moment I will, in lane 2, Kojikaru. Also in lane 5, that's Usha of India, and as you can see, Skoglund appears to have finished 5th.
It all comes with exposure, with the training, with exposure, because for me, no training partner also. I do training alone. Nobody is there to run with me. And no competition also for me. Every day I do training alone. This two, if you take about these two things and then my performance 55-4 and medal missed by 100, it's a very big achievement actually. You should run with the training partner should be there, competitor should be there, lot of exposure should be there, and a lot of supplements should be there. For me, nothing. This 5 things also is not there. And now physio is, when one athlete goes, one physio will be there for doing stretching exercise. And one massager will be there for your recovery. What massager? What physio? What exposure? Nothing for me, but still I could do well. That is why, see, without all those things, I had come near the Olympic medal and missed it by 100th second. If I can do without these facilities, why not others? This my mind only, I started academy after my retirement.
14, 15.
actually I had come in the sports field because I was very active in my childhood. So physical education teacher of my school, he noted my activeness and then he made me to run with the champion of the district. She was in 7th standard and I was in actually 4th standard. And drill period, he made me to run with her. And for me, I just want to win because I know that she's Chechi, like 3 years to me, you know, and she's the champion also. So I ran with her and I won the race. When I was in 7th standard, the district meet, like sub-jilla meet, I participate. And I won the all 100, long jump, high jump, short put, everything. Whatever I participate, I was the champion actually in sub-jilla Melody. Then luckily, when I passed 7th standard, Kerala government started sports division for girls. For boys, they have started 1 year before. But first time Kerala, starting for women, girls. So my parents are had a lot of interest and they took me to the sports school selection. So in every event, whatever all the event I participated in, I could get first in all the events and ranked first. Then I went to Trivandrum also for the state level selection and there also I ranked first. That is actually turning point. Then I could get the selection in Kannur sports division. When I went there, the system was totally changed. I should get up around 5 o'clock and go to the ground 6:30, I should be there. And 7:30, up to 8:30 for training. And we have that first year it was 40 athletes and next year it was 80. So hostel and all, it was not that good. See, one hostel, 8-9 people used to stay in one room. There is no grills in the room and there is no wall in the hostel. And for 40 athletes and all, two latrine and three bathrooms only. But we managed it. But the system was there. Municipal high school only I studied. There only I met Nambiar sir. From the district meet actually, it's not like a Melody sub-jilla meet. The lot of competition will be there because Kannur, St. Teresa's people athletes used to do training and they comes with the tracksuit and spikes. For me, I have not at all seen tracksuit also, no spikes also. But still, I came first in that meet. Then when I went to the first Palai state meet, I could not win. The same case there also. Most of them had come with the training and I am actually very raw. Then each itself I was out. And one girl called Sri Lata, she used to win I remember her dress, no, like maroon tracksuit, and she was standing in the victory ceremony like first, no, the proud this Sri Lata. Then from far I have seen that, and I already at mine, no, like next year I do good training and next year I'll be the champion. So bolke I went. Then it is not looked back. Usain Bolt I always love, like his race. My favorite hurdler, Edwin Moses, world record holder many times. So I used to keep his photo in my room every time when I used to do hurdles. Every hurdle in between, he do 13 strides. I love see that strides, 13 strides. It's running like a calculated strides he do. When he close eyes also, he'll go for 13 strides. I used to watch his hurdling every time. When I was staying in Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, one room, I used to keep his photo in my room. His hurdling photo was there. And I like Carl Lewis race also that time. He won 100, 200 and long jump. And his 100 meters, his acceleration, so I like to see his acceleration. And jumping, his double, technique. That also I love to see this thing.
1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 0.
Our athletes will win in future, no doubt, in athletics. Maybe within coming three Olympics, one medal will be there. One medal come athletics, then it will come more and more, then no doubt. It will catch up. One thing is there, that has to be break.
It's like a trigger, no?
It is a trigger. It has to be broken, no? Then it will come.